it's Chris Voss here from thechrisvossshow.com, thechrisvossshow.com. Okay, a blog post I want to share with you. We have the versus comparison fight you have been longing for. This is the new iPhone 5. We got two of them yesterday on September 21st, 2012. We're going to run a comparison between the iPhone 5 and the older brother or old brother, the iPhone 4S. And we're going to see what the difference is. We're going to benchmark it. We're going to do a bunch of camera work. And so stay tuned through the whole video as we go through this. Now, the iPhone 4S is about roughly a year old and in its build. And so let's see how it measures up. Now, of course, the two phones, one has an A6 processor chip, which is the iPhone 5. And the iPhone 4S has what's called an A5 chip in it. Now, the A6 chip that is in the iPhone 5 has what's called ARM, I believe it's a V7 technology. And basically what it does is it allows it to really rock and roll and have an increased ability of architecture to be able to really perform. And so roughly what it shows on our benchmarking test is a 1 gigahertz processor in here, where on the iPhone 4S, it shows an 800 gigahertz processor. They're both dual core, but with the ARM structures and how they're built, some of that gets taken out, and until you can do bench tests, which we'll do, you won't know. Now, they're all available on AT&T, Sprint, Verizon. They're both available in black and white. You can get them in 16, 32, and 64 gigabytes. The height of the iPhone 5 is 4.87 inches, and the height of the iPhone 4S is 4.5 inches. So the difference is 0.37 inches. So it's not quite a half. It's about almost there, but it's 0.37 inches, or yes, 0.37 inches taller. Now the width is exactly the same, 2.31 inches on both devices. One thing that is nice, some people complain about how the device is taller. One thing that is nice, since the device is thinner, it still doesn't feel like as much in your hands, given especially that the device is the same width, if that makes any sense. So it actually feels much lighter. The depth of it on the iPhone 5 is 0.30 inches, whereas the thickness depth of the iPhone 4S is 0.37 inches. So they shaved 0.07 inches off, which is very close to, knocking, 20% off? So that's a pretty good reduction in space. You'll get to see that here in a second. The weight on the iPhone 5 is 3.95 ounces, whereas the weight on the iPhone 4S is 4.9 ounces. So they're able to reduce it almost a whole ounce, just shy of a whole ounce. And you can really tell it's definitely a light phone. The iPhone 5 has got a 4-inch diagonal retina display, whereas the iPhone 4S is 3.5 diagonal retina display. And it's got on the iPhone 5, it's 1136 by 64 resolution. And on the iPhone 4S, it's 960 by 640 resolution. So the width is the same on the 640 side. They just increased the resolution roughly 200 and some odd or something. 9, 10, 11, some change. So, I don't know, 250, you can do the math, I'll let you do that. So the PPI has remained the same, which is your retina display, 326 points per inch. And then on cellular wireless, of course, you have it available like you normally would. It actually has on the iPhone 5 a smaller, what's called nano card. It's much smaller than the micro SIM card that you find on the iPhone 4S. So it got even weirder that way, where everything is shrinking. Both have an 8-megapixel camera. The optics have been made better, they say, in the iPhone 5. I guess we'll do some camera work and test it out and all that good stuff. On the FaceTime camera, which is the forward-facing camera on the iPhone 5, you're looking at 1.2-megapixel photos with 720 HD video. On the back, of course, you have 1080p. And the iPhone 4S, they don't really specify. They just say it's a VGA resolution photo and VGA resolution video. They didn't really say what it is. So you definitely have HD now forward facing on the iPhone 5, and you definitely have, of course, HD on the back. Both have FaceTime, of course, video recording. They both have 1080p, HD, 30 frames per second. They come out with some new earpods. We'll show you this here in a bit. Some new earpods that come with the iPhone 5, but really doesn't have to do with our Versus comparison, so you may or may not see them. The connector is different. They put a different connector on the iPhone 5. I love it. It's so nice not to have to try and figure out if you're up or down or sideways or what with a stupid plug, because I always plug it in wrong and I plug it in the dark before I'm going to bed. Or sometimes in the middle of the night, I'm like remembering, oh, I got to plug it in so it's charged. So I love the new lightning plug, where with the iPhone 4S, you have to put it in right or you damage your device or you won't charge, and it's just a nightmare. Doesn't look like talk times change on 3G. They're both 8 hours. On LTE, it says about browsing time is 8 hours on LTE. Standby time says up to 225 hours as opposed to the iPhone 4S, which is says standby time is 200 hours. So they did a little bit of a boost to the battery in the iPhone 5. So that's going to give us an idea of how these two operate. Now, you can see the difference in the screen size here when we really look at the two of them and compare them side by side. There's no difference in the width, but basically you get an extra row of icons is how you look at it. I really like it because you're also getting an extra row of information, and that can be really nice for when you're trying to read a screen and do everything. I found I'm enjoying more games or trying to do more with the iPhone 5 because I can see farther down the screen. Of course, here you can see on the iPhone 4S, we're not getting as much information as I can get with the 5. And sometimes that makes just that little bit of difference of saving me a lot of work of paging down. Oh, paging down, the horror. But no, it does make a difference when you're watching a movie on Netflix or Hulu Plus. You can actually watch it kind of more in a widescreen mode if you would, and that makes all the difference, you know, going forward. Okay, so let's take a look at both devices. What we have on the iPhone 5, we have the front-facing camera, which is above the speaker. There's a small speaker there for phone calls, and then you have a, I believe this is a sensor that senses if your face is close to the device. You also have your standard home button that you have on all the Apple devices. You also have iOS devices, I should say. You also have a front-facing camera, which is to the left of the speaker on the iPhone 4S. Okay, so now here you can see the back of both devices. Now, on the iPhone 4S, we've added a sticker magnet thing that lenses can be able to stick to the back of the iPhone on. So this would not be normal on an iPhone 4S that you would get. You can see here it has a beautiful glass back. There's the flash and all that good stuff. I have chipped the back, and so one of the things I'm really happy about is with the new iPhone 5, it's got a metal back plate in this piece. These two are kind of some very thin glass that are covering the Wi-Fi and the ability to, you know, to call the telephone companies, all that good stuff, your antenna. But I love this steel back. I only have to worry about dropping face down and breaking the screen as opposed to the iPhone 4S. I can pretty much break both sides. And it's, I got a 50-50 chance over here. So you can see here on the iPhone, there appears to be a small microphone that's between both the camera and the flash. I'm not sure if that's what it is exactly, but it appears to be some sort of device to that specification. Probably great for picking up recordings of what you're taking and recording on your video, your audio. So that's the back, and I'm really in love with the new back. One of the problems I've had, I'll tell you what my personal opinion is, I lock up my iPhone in cases, and they spend 24 hours a day in cases, and every now and then I pull it out, and I go, this is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. The problem is, I never see it. I never get to really touch it or play with it. It's always wrapped up in a case, because I'm afraid of dropping it and breaking it. The beautiful part about the iPhone 4S is it's lighter, so it's going to survive drops better, and it's also less filled with a bunch of glass. So I like that aspect of it. Okay, so here you can see the real difference between the two in their thickness. There's two giant pieces of glass that protrude from the frame on the iPhone 4S, and I'm really glad those are gone. There's just a really light, thin piece of glass in the front of the iPhone 5, but it certainly means that you're going to chip less, break less, screen, all that good stuff. I've chipped out the side corner of the glass, and so I'm really happy to be rid of that feature of the iPhone 4S. You can see here, of course, they've changed the speakers on the iPhone 5. They have a really cool design that I like. They do seem to be more open and hopefully will output more sound. I love the new plug. Like I said, it's great. And the earphone plug in the bottom, hey, whatever floats your boat, fine with me. The 30-pin connector on the bottom of the iPhone 4S, I'm so happy to say goodbye. It's not even funny. The smaller plug that you plug into charge in the iPhone 5 is quick, easy, brainless. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to look at it. You just jam it in and go. It works really, really well. And the design of it's really beautiful, too. You can kind of see it has kind of a mirrored entrance where the iPhone 4 just kind of has this hard steel. You can also see when you look closely at it, you can see the mirrored edge of the iPhone 5, whereas with the iPhone 4S, it's just kind of a hard, round piece with the kind of a, it's not a rough edge because it's definitely machined, but it's not beveled and pretty like the iPhone 5 is. All right, so here you can see the tops of both devices. There's the power buttons pretty much about in the same place. You can also really see the difference between getting rid of all that glass that you have on both sides of the iPhone 5, and it fits just nicely into the metal frame that's in the iPhone 5. And of course, you can see there's a speaker, an earphone hole, and also a monitor, sound monitor, microphone that's in the top. Not much has changed in this type of build, other than basically the iPhone 5 has got thinner, as you can see here. Getting rid of that glass, I mean, it just completely disappears with the iPhone 5, and you don't miss it, let me tell you. The great thing about the phone is that 1 ounce, it's 25% lighter, basically, and you can feel it. It definitely is a lighter phone, and it feels better in your hand, especially with the metal back as opposed to the slippery glass back. All right, so here you can see the slot for the SIM card is much smaller, mainly because it is a much smaller SIM card slot. It's called a nano SIM, which is very different than a micro SIM. I don't know where you go from there, microscopic SIM, who knows. But you can see here definitely the thinness of it and everything else. You know, you really start looking at the beauty of the beveled edges of the iPhone 5, and you look at just how hard it makes the iPhone 4S edges look just kind of plain. See what I'm talking about? See how these edges are nice and beveled and pretty and machined? And these are just plain. It just looks like cheap banding. After you look at it for a while, you're like, oh my gosh, what did I buy the first time? So I'm not kidding. You really get spoiled with the iPhone 5. Okay, now this is one thing I really noticed about playing with the phones yesterday. If you really look at the edges, and this is something I've been talking to a lot of people about, this beveled and machined mirrored edge here gives a really pretty tone to the phones. Whereas when you look at the iPhone, it's, you know, kind of rounded, but it's pretty much just looks like a band somebody twisted around it of steel. It doesn't have that same effect of that beautiful mirrored cut edge that you can see here. And you can see, if you look closely, my image sometimes coming through. Whereas with this thing, it's just a steel round band pretty much. It makes it look quite a bit more boring on the iPhone 4S, and it definitely pops out, as you can see, on the iPhone 5. I really like it. I think it's very pretty, and it offers an exceptional accent to the iPhone 5. So be sure to check that out when you're looking at these phones. Now, these were tests done, and of course we turned the Wi-Fi back on, but these were tests that were originally done in a non-Wi-Fi situation to each of the respective carriers on each of these devices. In this case, AT&T runs on the network with the 4G LTE for the iPhone 5. Now, the iPhone 4S doesn't have 4G LTE or 4G capability. It's still stuck in 3G mode. So its download and upload processes are fairly limited, and also limited by the carrier, as are both phones technically when it comes down to it. This particular 4S is from Verizon, and you can compare the two. One of the issues that there still is that's really interesting, considering the iPhone 4 is supposed to be the latest technology, with Verizon on the iPhone 5 and Sprint, you still cannot, to this day, this has been going on for years, You cannot download data while you're on the phone talking to somebody. And that is what keeps a lot of people with AT&T. And, of course, we have this phone from AT&T. That's because we got to talk to people and download data at the same time. So that's really a difference between these two different companies. But it's also a major difference between these two phones. It's kind of apples to oranges. But if you're someone who's considering upgrading to an iPhone 5, that's why we make these videos for you. You can see what you're getting on your download speeds and what you could be getting. Quite a bit of difference, huh? That's almost worth paying for a new phone in and of itself, especially if you're using your phone for business. Shows as an 800 megahertz device. And, of course, the real difference is what goes into them. They're both, of course, dual core. Memory, 1,016 megabytes. I've heard everything from one to that. 505 megabytes on the iPhone 4S. If you believe what these say, you're basically doubling your memory. You're increasing your power by, I don't know, what, 30%, 25%, which makes a considerable difference, especially with the, I mean, this ARM V7 that they used on the Apple chip was very innovative in being able to get extreme processor speeds. Everything that we're seeing come out of the benchmarking that's being done on the iPhone 5, it's pantsing and beating every smartphone that's out there on the market. There might be one or two select cases of benchmark that it's not, but for the most part, it's skunking everybody, including the Samsung Galaxy S3, which at one point was the king of fast when it came to some of the best smartphones that were out there. You can see here that the iPhone 5 is completely done, and meanwhile, the iPhone 4S is only about halfway done when the first screen popped up. You can see here the results of the Geekbench score is 1638, which is a pretty good average. Now you can really see the difference of why maybe moving to an iPhone 4S to an iPhone 5 might work for you. You can see the scoring here. I mean, the scoring is almost triplicated to go to the iPhone 5, and it really is about the architecture they put into the chip, the new chip. You can see here on integer-wise, it beats it by double, beats it by triple, roughly beats it by almost triple, 2.5 times. Stream-wise, beats it by triple and then some. So definitely you can really see the speeds here on what you're buying. This isn't a cheap upgrade or a small update. This is a major killer phone, and you really don't want to underestimate it. It's very cool and very different when it does its processes. Integer scores you can see here. Let's go ahead and page down. Floating point scores, you can see here how they broke down. The great thing about these scores is if you have a different phone at home, you can download most of these apps and you can take and do a comparison on your phone to see how your phone benchmarks with the iPhone 5 and the iPhone 4S. Now what we're doing is we're running a Passmark benchmark test, and you can see how it's processing the frames per second and how things operate on the device and its ability to speedily process images and everything else. If you are someone who maybe is epileptic, or these images might be something that might incur something you need health-wise, you may want to look away for a second. But we'll see here some of the graphics, and you can see how well the iPhone processes graphics comparatively to the iPhone 4S, the iPhone 5 does. Quite a difference just when you look at the graphics side by side and the speed and operating way that it goes about itself. The games are much funner to play on the iPhone 5 because they're bigger and you can see more, and that makes them very cool. So let's go and submit both these benchmarks so we can take a look at what we're doing and what we're getting. Now you can see here, if you look at both the bottoms and the tops of these, basically what they've done is they've shortened this by a little bit on the bottom and shortened it on the top, and basically made it so that they could get more screen size in here. So definitely the part here and here is much shorter on the iPhone 4S, or on the iPhone 5 as comparatively to the iPhone 4S. Okay, so let's take a look at some of these numbers here with the benchmarking. You can see once again the extreme difference of these two phones and their processing capabilities. 1887 is what the iPhone 4S got as a score on the system. 3730 38, pretty much double the processing iOS, CPU, memory information, all that sort of good stuff when it put it through the competitive test. These numbers blow away, and they blow away pretty hard when it comes to like even comparing these with Android phones, because a lot of Android phones don't even score this high. 8,373 CPU on the iPhone 4S, whereas with the iPhone 5, 23,000. It's almost like, what is that? Almost three times faster. Just crazy speed. I mean, they really built the iPhone 5 to be a monster for speed. And really, if you're starting to notice, you're getting 2 to 3 times a better phone. Disk-wise, 5813 against 13856, 2,446 memory. And the read-write, you've got 1769 with the 4S. With the 2D graphic, you've got 607. You got 607 with the 2D graphics, where you have 1649 with the 2D graphics, and then with the 3D, you got 1205 and 1728. I imagine the 3D didn't change much, because for the most part, with 3D, you're running pretty much the same sort of PPI that we have on both these, and with both of them being Retina display, not much is probably going to change there. What we're going to do is go and do a browser mark test so that we can go through and see how well this performs on a browser mark thing, and we can see how that's going to go there for us. Okay, so now to be fair with both these phones, we turn their brightness up to the highest setting. Because of the slider, it's hard to get accurate on where you are exactly, so we've just jammed up the settings all the way. We've taken pictures on top of each other with the iPhone 4S and the iPhone 5. Now, one thing we've noticed is the colors are brighter on the iPhone 5. They definitely pop more. It's a slight edge over the iPhone 4S, but it definitely is a difference maker when you really look at great photos. Is it worth going out and buying a new phone for? I don't think so, but I would really say if you add up all the factors that I've talked about in these videos, you can definitely make an argument for it, in my mind. Should you use your last penny? Probably not, but make sure it's, you know, disposable income. So you can see here the iPhone 5 is on the top, and we've got a case put around it. And on this, the reds, the greens, the yellows pop so much more. You can see here the tree is much more beautiful. It even looks more in focus. The reds over here and the bushes here, comparatively, you can hardly see the reds stand out over here. But the reds over here definitely pop out. Let's see if we can't get both these to come out. Can you see the difference in the reds? Really big difference. And I don't know how much it's being picked up on our recording device that we have here. The picture looks sharper and more in focus, at least in my mind. Yellow, the sign looks more yellow. So definitely the colors seem to pop a whole lot more between the two different devices. Let's take a look at the video we took on both of these. Now, you'll also notice that you're getting a wider angle of recording. See how in this case the car is cut off, and in the other case we can see more of the car. Let's go ahead and do that again, and we'll see if we can't get that going on. Looks like we had the pause going. So you're definitely getting a wider shot on these. Let's go ahead and take another look at those. And once again, when we took these photos, we took them on top of each other where the cameras were in the same exact place. You can see here it's much wider on that side, much wider on that side. So big difference in the width of your photos and what you're going to take and capture with the iPhone 5 is comparatively. Now, here's the picture that you're going to see with the iPhone 4S. You can also see the colors here. This almost looks kind of hazy here with the iPhone 4S. The iPhone 5, the colors are rich, dark, and of course you can see the aperture is much different in how much it's capturing out in its surroundings. Now, these are taken from the same exact location, same exact place, against the Tranny bottle. So you can see here it picks up a lot more data and material in its photo captures, where this is just picking up a very small window. So they made some definitely significant changes to the iPhone 5. Let's take a look. Now, these are, once again, taken from the same exact place, same exact distance. And you can see here that the colors, the yellow, the reds, the yellows, and blues, definitely stand out a whole lot more. And the real big deal here is just in how those colors really, really pop. And I don't know if you can see them, but definitely the red is definitely hitting more. It almost looks washed out in the iPhone 4S. Huge, huge difference in how those are coming out. See, that almost looks washed out in the red, especially the blue too. And you can see the blue looks much richer, much darker here. Let's take a look at this. Now, this is a low light photo. What they've done is with the iPhone 5 is they've increased the quality of the low light photography that you can take and do. Here's the 4S. It's a great picture in a low light situation with the flash, getting a lot of blowback of light, especially in these black areas you can see here. Here you can see the colors are more rich, the reds, the purples. I mean, go ahead and look at the purples and the reds together. You can see that they're much more richer down here, whereas the iPhone 5 actually looks washed out. This is kind of making me sad because I'm like, I always thought I had a great camera. And you still do with the iPhone 4S. But see how the red's popping way much more on the iPhone 5. There definitely is a huge difference in those colors. And from what I'm seeing, the photo quality is a lot more clear, a lot more good clarity, and just a lot more richer in color. Here's a low-light situation where we're using the lamp, which of course is kind of the flash when you really look at it. You can see here that, once again, the colors are richer, the reds, the blues, and everything else, and a whole big difference in the photos there. So low light, they rock really well, and then in well-lit situations, rocks even better. They've done a great job with the cameras on the iPhone 5, and for me, that's almost enough reason to upgrade, because your colors are richer, you've got a wider range of stuff that it's going to take and pick up. That was one of the factors, if I can bring up another phone, the Samsung Galaxy S3. One of the factors that I really liked about it is because its cameras picked up a much wider area than the iPhone 4S. So I'm really happy to see similar results on the iPhone 5, that it's picking up more area and more context. And of course, it has a bigger screen to play that back to you. So I love the new camera on the iPhone 5. Okay, so that's it. You've seen the benchmarking. You've seen the comparisons between the two phones. I got to tell you, I love the iPhone 5. It's thinner. It's lighter. It makes a huge amount of difference to me in that factor. I feel if I drop it, it's probably going to survive a drop because it is lighter. You know, just that being able to go like this with the phone and be able to comfortably hold it with one finger is really cool. I like that, where the iPhone 5 or the iPhone 4S actually feels like a brick in the hand. It's super fast, especially when you combine the super fastness of the processor against the 4G LTE speed you're going to get on a 4G network. It's going to be whipping fast with downloading, putting programs on, all that good stuff. I think it's awesome. Decide which phone is right for you, if the upgrade is right for you. And we can show you, you can, of course, see that you're getting almost 2 to 3 times a better phone with the iPhone 5. I think it's a great investment. I think it's a beautiful new investment. And it almost makes the iPhone 5 4S, from what I've showed you, look a little antiquated. So be sure to check it out. Be sure to follow up with the ChrisVossShow.com off and on the comparison videos we do. Hopefully this is helpful for you to decide to do what to do. You can do what I did. I just added a second line and got a discounted phone. I paid like $40 or $50 an extra a month or something for it, but love the phone. Thanks for coming by, guys. See you later.